My name's Amy McIntyre, and I'm a water sampling student at Lambton Public Health this summer. So I study public health, and I'm doing a minor in environmental sustainability. So this is an environmental health component of health protection. So it's just really interesting to see how the lab tests the results, and the statistical analysis is very interesting. So if a swimmer comes up to a beach and they're having a beach day on vacation, they can typically look at the water. If it's cloudy or murky or anything, that's a red flag for E. coli conditions. If they know that there's been high rainfall in the last 48 hours or a storm came through, that also stirs up the water because there'll be high wave activity. And then there'll be the E. coli at the bottom of the lake will be stirred up and it'll be more present. We're testing the beach water for E. coli levels. High E. coli levels mean that your health will be at risk. You have a risk of infection or gastrointestinal illnesses. And low levels means that you can swim in it and it's safe. When I show up to a beach, then I put my life jacket on. I head down to the beach with my golf ball collector, which that's only used to put my bottle in it so that I can put the bottle in the water without touching and coming into contact with the bottle. So we do it all in Lambton County. So we start in Sarnia, go to Canaterra, go to Brights Grove, Ipperwash Beach, Grand Bend South, and Grand Bend North. So there's five different areas. And then we take samples five different times at each location. We collect five bottles, and those five bottles go to a laboratory to be tested, and then we have one extra bottle for turbidity, and that's what we use for the testing. Our prediction models were developed from past sampling data. Samples are then sent to the lab, and the results will be used to verify that our prediction models are working properly. Then I take the sample back to my truck to test for environmental parameters such as turbidity and pH. These are then used to help determine our prediction. There's like an equation, and we put the meteorological conditions into this equation, and then it gives us a number. So if that number is over 200, then that's a warning. So that's high levels of E. coli and it's dangerous for swimming. And anything less is considered just caution because there's always a bacteria, E. coli bacteria, on the bottom level of the lake. With our predictions and the laboratory results that from the 2018 season, our results have been very accurate so far. Based on our past history, we take meteorological conditions. So this includes your sun intensity, your wave direction and wave intensity, the wind direction and the wind speed. And we test the air temperature as well as the water temperature to see the accuracy and see higher levels of warm water may provoke E. coli levels. So we always have a caution sign. There's no green go sign because there's always a level of bacteria on the bottom of the lake. But we switch the sign when it's over that number of 200 to a warning just to assure you that the water is unsafe, but it's to your own risk. I like knowing that I can protect my family as well as my community, but not even my community, it's people coming in. We have a lot of tourists that come to our beautiful beaches to see our sunsets and sunrise and swim. So I like knowing that I can protect their health.